Hello guys, and welcome to Python programming tutorials by Amul's Academy. So in the previous tutorial we discussed about how we can draw stars in the heart shape. So today in this tutorial, if I want to enter any message inside that heart shape, then how to do that, we'll see that. So before that, this is the program which we discussed in the previous tutorial. So this is very lengthy, so I can reduce few lines here. So here, instead of these four lines, I'll write this code in a single line, okay? So like this. So first I'll use print, and I want space how many times? This times, okay? So I'll write space multiply n minus I minus one time. This is the multiplication symbol, so it will print space this many times, okay? So next I'll write, I want to print star how many times? I plus one time, okay? Space how many times? I plus one time, okay? So next here end will be empty string. So instead of these four lines, I'll write it in a single line. So I'll remove it. So next here also, okay, instead of these five lines, I'll write it in a single line. So just use print. So space num minus I times. So space into num minus I times plus, this is the concatenation symbol. Next I want to print star I times. So here multiply I times, okay, done. So I'll remove this. So here I didn't took end is equal to empty string, that's why it will print a new line after each row, okay? So now if I run this now, so 8, okay, we'll get the output, okay? So next I want to print name or any message inside the heart, okay, in the center of the heart. So for that, first what I'll do is I'll take name or any message, okay? So if I take message, I'll take input, ask the user to enter any message. All right, so I want it to be string, that's why I won't convert it to any other type, okay? So by default it will take input as string, so that's what I want here. So next what I'll do is I'll take another variable called L, and I'll find out the length of this message. That means if you enter name, how many characters are present, I want that length, okay? That's why I'll use length function and I'll calculate that, okay? So now done. So now here in this pattern we'll print name here, okay? So this is 1, 2 and this is third part. After 1 and 2 part, okay, here there is a gap, right? Here we'll print name. So that is nothing but before this here. So what I'll do is I'll take print and I'll go for message. Now if I save this and run this, enter number 6 message as Amul. Okay, so it will print like this, but I don't want it to be like this, okay? Here, after each star, I printed a space, right? In the print, we can see. After, here we can see, after star, I printed a space, okay? In that same way, in this message, I want space between each character, okay? So here, if I enter Amul, so in the program, I want like A, M, U, L. Okay, like this. So for this what I'll do is here I'll use this dot join, okay? So if I save this and run this, okay, it will print like this. Now I want it to be in the center, and I want start before and after this message, okay? So that's nothing but like this, okay? If the total number of star is 6, then I want like this A M U L, there are 4 character, then 1 star, then 1 star after the message, Okay, I want like this. So for this, what I'll do is, so I'll write a formula. So that is nothing but here I want star and a space. How many times? So here num is the maximum column, right? So I'll take num minus el, okay, divided by 2. Okay, and here I'll take concatenation symbol, and I want same amount of stars after this message, so I'll print that. So if I save this and run this, okay, it will print like this, but this star is not printing properly because of here. I'll put space before that, okay. Okay, so now we are getting proper output. So here I use num minus l divided by 2 because in the program num is nothing but total number of columns, okay, whatever the input given by the user, and l is nothing but length of the message, okay. So if you enter number of column as 8, so num value is 8 and message as AMUL, okay. So now AMUL, I'll print that. After that I want to make it 8, so I'll add 2 stars before and after that message, okay. So now it becomes 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, total length is 8, okay. So to do this I need to print 2 stars here. So for that I wrote that formula. So that is nothing but num is 8 and length is here 4, so 8 minus 4, so we'll get 4, okay. So that is nothing but print 2 star before the message, print 2 star after the message. So that's why here I took divided by 2, okay. Here we use truncated division because we want integer as the output, that's why. So next we need to check this program for 4 types of input, okay. So the first one is when the entered column is even and the length of the message, whatever you return, right, is even, okay, both are even. The second condition is when column is even but length is odd, okay. For example, you entered a message with 5 characters, then length is 5, odd. And the next condition is when column is odd and length even. So next condition is column number is odd and length is odd, okay. So I need to check these 4 condition, okay. So first I'll check column is even, message length is even, okay. I'll check this program for that. So here I need to take both input should be even, so I'll take 8, it is a even, so message as AMUL, okay. So we are getting proper output. So again, if you want to check another, I'll take 10. All right, so now fine. So one condition satisfies, okay. So here done. So next I need to check is column even, length odd, length of message should be odd. So 8, this says AMULs, okay. No, I'm not getting proper output. Here we can see, okay. Okay, so for this condition I need to write separate condition. So what I'll do is here I'll check all the 4 condition. So I'll write this condition for all 4 condition, okay. So here cut, okay. So here first I'll take if num, it is to check whether entered column number is even. If it is even, then I need to check l whether it is even or odd. If both are even, then that condition becomes true, right? So this condition is true. Else, so this is the condition which we checked now, okay. So this condition won't satisfy, So I'll add plus one here because we need an extra star there. So okay, done. So we got the output for this also. So done with this condition also. Next, column odd and length even. So for that, first I'll write the condition, okay? I need to write the else part also, right? So copy, and here I'll write else, control V. So now I'll check this condition. That is nothing but column is odd, length is even. Column odd, so I'll enter 9. Length even, AMUL, 4. Here we can see there is a short of 1 star. So here I'll add plus 1. Okay. Okay, so we are getting output for this also, right? Length is even, this is odd. So this condition also satisfies now. So left is last condition, column odd, length odd. So column 9, message AMULS, 5 character. Okay, we are getting an extra star. Okay, so we don't want that. So that this is the condition. So I need to remove this. And now I'll run it. Okay, so 9 AMULS, both are odd. Okay, so we are getting the output for this also. This also done. So I think we covered all the condition. So now last time I'll check for an random output. Okay, I'll take 10 and I'll write AMULS Jammy. Okay, so we are getting like this because the length of message is larger than the column number. Okay, so be careful about that. If you want to print a particular message, then check the column number. It should be greater than the message. Okay, so be careful about that. So if I enter 20 and this AMULS Academy, so then it will fit nicely, right? Okay, it will give the output. Okay, so this is about how we can print a message in the center of the heart. So you may have other ideas, you may know other ways to write this program. If you have any other, then don't forget to comment below. Okay, so that's it for now, guys. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I will meet you in next class. Till then, take care.